A very good morning, grade 2. This is chapter number 20, In the Sky. In this chapter, we are going to learn about so many good things which we call heavenly bodies. And what is heavenly bodies? The star, the moon and the sun. When we see all of them in the sky, these are called the heavenly bodies, which is not a part of our earth, but they are outside the earth and they are the part of the space, or you can say of the galaxy. But we can see these things by our, you can say, nude eyes. We can see them all. It easily can be visible every day and night. We see the sun in the morning time, and the moon and star we see when it dark outside, or you can say in the night. So we see the sun, the moon and the stars in the sky. These are called heavenly bodies. We call them heavenly bodies. First of all, we talk about the sun. As you can see, I draw a sun here. It looks yellow in color, or it is round in shape. And we all see sun in the morning, in the daytime, every day. Sometimes when it's a cloudy day, we cannot see a sun, but it takes place every, you can say, it comes every day. It never be late. It always be rises and sets on the west. We talk about more on sun. So first of all, we talk about the sun is a star. Yes, we don't know this thing. We see all the stars. They look in white in color every day in the night time. But the sun looks yellow in color. But yes, it is also a star. It is the closest star to the earth. This star is very closest to the earth. Rest other stars are very far away from the earth. That's why they look so much tiny in their sizes. We see all the stars. That is also a ball shaped, but we see they are very far away from us. So we cannot see them in a round shape. They look in a star shape, which we draw usually. But they are also round in shape and they are also very hot, as the sun is very hot. Okay, next. The sun rises in the east and sets in the west. Every day in the morning, sun rises from the east side and it sets on the west side every day in our life. Now, it gives us heat and light. Sun se hame roshni milti hai aur hame garmi milti hai. Now, you all think, why we need heat and why do we need a light? As you can see, right now I'm standing in front of you all and making the video for you all, a lecture. And I will not switch turn on any kind of light here. Only one single bulb is switched on. But rest other light is coming out from the windows. This light is coming from the sunlight. And due to this light, you can easily see me. And I am visible to you all. So we all need light every day, as well as heat as well. If we cannot see a sun, we cannot get a heat. And it's a cold weather every time, all the time on the earth. So sun gives us heat as well. By this, we can survive. Now, the sunlight, green plants make food with the help of sunlight. When the sun occurs and the sunlight comes on the plant, all the plants make their food by using that sunlight. The leaves make the food for the plant by doing the process of photosynthesis. They prepare their food for the plant. But for that, they all need sunlight. By using sunlight, all the plants make their food. Next. The sunlight helps in killing germs and keep us healthy. We all get vitamin D by the help of sunlight. Hame bahut energy milti hai sunlight se. So we should take sunlight every day. Okay, it helps to kill the germs as well. Outer germs also kill by the sunlight. The heat of the sun melts the snow to fill rivers with water. How it helps? Now I will tell you the process of all this. When the sunlight, you know, puts on rivers and you can say lakes or ponds or any other water body, when the sunlight comes on that water body, the water gets evaporated. Okay, it started burning and it gets evaporated. When the water is evaporated, it goes up, the air goes up. On one place, when the air goes up, on one place that started making cool, and they collect all the water which started evaporate from the water bodies, they convert it into the clouds, and those clouds started raining when they become so heavy. By this process we all get rain, or you can say rainwater on earth again. So sunlight is helpful for this purpose as well. Next we talk about, it also helps to change water into water vapor. As I told you, the water converted into water vapor, and the water vapor go and collect into the clouds, and then the water comes down when the cloud becomes so much heavy. The sun is the main source of heat and light on the earth. Without sun we cannot get any kind of heat as well as light. So sun is very much helpful for all of us. By the light and heat of the sun we can survive. So sun is very very hot. We cannot go near to the sun because it's a hot air ball. So we cannot touch it, or we cannot go on sun. So I hope you all understand what is sun, what are the heavenly bodies. On the next lecture we are going to talk about moon as well as stars. Thank you so much students, and have a nice day. Bye everyone.